There's a Channel 4 booklet guide on opera and singing around the world. If you'd like a copy, just send a cheque or postal order for £1.50 made payable to Channel 4 to The Singing Voice, P.O. Box 4000, London W36XJ, or Glasgow G12 9JQ, or Belfast BT2 7FE. Next week, the 1981 Metropolitan Opera production of Verdi's A Masked Ball with Luciano Pavarotti and Katia Riccarelli.
Hello, I'm Jan Parry, and I'll be introducing the very different performances that make up this year's dance season on Channel 4. City Ballet in Who Cares? The start of a new season of Dance on 4 this Wednesday at 9 o'clock.
Anthony Howard presents another edition of Face the Press here on Channel 4, just after the Channel 4 news summary with subtitles presented by Martin Lewis. Until then, we'll leave you with some music. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
To mark the start of British Television's first ever season of African films, the 11th Hour presents Africa on Africa, Caméra d'Afrique.
It was to take 68 years after the invention of cinema before a film from Black Africa could emerge on international screens.
The film surveys the birth and development of indigenous African cinema.
A new era had started in the history of cinema. A different cinema was about to emerge.
And this development is traced in Africa on Africa, Caméra d'Afrique, at the 11th Hour tomorrow, here on 4. And it's time now on 4 to cross over to ITN for the latest news summary from Martin Lewis.
British Rail have launched a full inquiry into last night's sleeper train crash in Northumberland, which left nearly 40 people injured. Seven sleeper carriages left the rails on a bend near Morpeth Station, the scene of another crash 15 years ago in which six people died. The driver of last night's Aberdeen to London train is among three people still in hospital. He's got a broken arm. The miners' leader, Mr. Arthur Scargill, has renewed his call for steelmen to increase their support for the coal strike. He told a rally in Cresswell, Derbyshire, that the best way to ensure the future of threatened steelworks was for the steelmen to join the miners in their struggle. A Greek supertanker has been hit in an attack by Iraqi planes in the Gulf. The 150,000-ton Alexander the Great, loaded with oil, was hit near the Iranian terminal at Harg Island, but was able to continue its voyage. Up to 1 million demonstrators have taken to the streets of Paris to protest at government plans to reform private education. Thousands of riot police were standing by in case of trouble, but the demonstration passed off peacefully. Sport now, and Sebastian Coe was beaten into second place by Peter Elliott in the 1500 metres at Crystal Palace and now looks unlikely to defend his title in that event at the Olympics next month. Steve Cram cast doubt over his appearance in Los Angeles by limping off the track after winning the 800 metres. He said he'd aggravated an Achilles tendon injury. The England cricket selectors have picked two new faces for the second test against the West Indies. Chris Broad of Nottinghamshire and Martin Moxon of Yorkshire replace Andy Lloyd, who's injured, and Derek Randall. Those are the Channel 4 headlines. The next news from ITN is on ITV at 6:30.
And now a look at the weather. There'll be some light rain or drizzle in most places overnight, but many regions will be dry again by daybreak. Tomorrow, after a cloudy start, it'll gradually turn brighter with a few sunny intervals, especially in central and eastern regions. In western Scotland and Northern Ireland, patches of light rain are likely, and near western coasts of England and Wales, there may be patches of drizzle and mist. It'll be a little warmer than today, but rather windy in the north and west. And that's the weather. And now on 4, Virginia Wade is invited to Face the Press.